हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू स्टैंडर्ड 9 सब्जेक्ट मैथमेटिक्स। दिस इज लेसन नंबर 2 पॉलीनोमियल्स इन लेक्चर नंबर 7। इन लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव अंडरस्टूड अबाउट द रिमाइंडर थ्योरम एंड रिलेटेड टू दैट एक्सरसाइज 2.3 वी हैव डन। आफ्टर दैट द न्यू टॉपिक वी हैव द फैक्टराइजेशन ऑफ पॉलीनोमियल्स। एज यू नो अबाउट द फैक्टराइजेशन इन अर्लियर क्लासेस ऑल्सो यू हैव फैक्टराइज्ड द गिवन पॉलीनोमियल्स। हियर we will see that in detail, and by factor theorem here the new topic is for you, factor theorem. What is it that we understand? If Px is a polynomial of degree n is greater than or equal to 1, polynomial's degree may be 1 or 2 or 3 or 4, 1 or greater than 1, and a is a real any real number, a is any real number, then we have two things. First, x minus a is a factor of px if pa equal to 0, and second number, if pa equal to 0 if x minus a is a factor of px. Actually this thing we have seen in last examples also, how to check that the given expression is a factor of polynomial or not. So you know that we were trying to get the remainder, and in remainder theorem you know what is remainder, r equals to pa. So here it is pa, and if remainder is 0, x minus a is a factor, and if x minus a is a factor, pa equals 0. That is only the recall, and it is given a given factor here. So once again, it's very simple. The factor theorem is, when you can say x minus a is a factor of px if pa equal to 0, and when you can say pa equal to 0 if x minus a is a factor of px. This is to be deciding factor in factor theorem. So now we have the next example 11. Using factor theorem we have to use in next coming examples. For example 11 is, examine whether x plus 2 is a factor of x cube plus 3x square plus 5x plus 6 and of 2x plus 4. We have to check this, that x plus 2 is a factor of this polynomial and this polynomial or not. So both of that polynomial, for both the polynomials we will check this x plus 2 is a factor or not. To check the factor, the factors 0 we have to find first, as in remainder theorem we have seen, and this we have to see that the remainder is 0 or not. If remainder you are finding by remainder theorem and it is coming 0, what do you say by factor theorem? It is a x minus a is a factor. So similar thing we will use here. So first our work will be, we want to check that x plus 2 is a factor or not. So we will find the 0 of this factor. So 0 of x plus 2, how to find, implies x plus 2 equal to 0, and that will be x equals to minus 2, gives x equal to minus 2. So this x equals to minus 2 is a 0 of x plus 2, which we want to check as a factor of 1. So this minus 2 of x value we have to replace in both the polynomials for which we want to check that the polynomials, for that the x plus 2 is factor of 1. So we consider this polynomial, let px equals to, this polynomial is x cube plus 3x square plus 5x plus 6, and the another polynomial 2x plus 4 we consider as sx, sx equals to 2x plus 4. Now x will be replaced by minus 2, because x equals to minus 2, the 0 of the factor we have, 0 of the expression we have. We will replace by that to find remainder by remainder theorem. So x is replaced by minus 2, minus 2 cube plus 3 into minus 2 square plus 5 into minus 2 plus 6. So it will be minus 2 cube will be minus 8, 3 into minus 2 square is plus 4, plus minus minus 5 will be 10, 6 as it is. When minus 8 as it is, 3 4s are 12, minus 10 plus 6 as it is. Now you see, plus numbers are plus 12 and plus 6, they will be 18, and minus numbers are minus 8 and minus 10, they will be minus 18. Plus 18 and minus 18, it will be 0. Similarly, in Sx also we have checked Sx equals to 2x plus 4. In that, x is replaced by minus 2. So s minus 2 equal to 2 into minus 2 plus 4. 2 into minus 2 will be minus 4 plus 4. Minus 4 plus 4 cancel, it gives 0. So in both of the given polynomial, the 0 of this expression gives remainder as 0. So you can use the factor theorem. If p a equal to 0, x minus a is a factor. So if p minus 2 is equal to 0, p minus 2 equal to 0, x plus 2 is a factor. So that is one only here. Hence by factor theorem, if p minus 2 equal to 0 here and x minus 2 0 here also, so x plus 2 is a factor of px as well as sx both. This way we can check by factor theorem that the given expression is a factor of the given polynomial of norm. One more example we have here. Example 12. Find the value of k if x minus 1 is a factor of 4x cube plus 3x square minus 4x plus k. So in solution, as here it is given that x minus 1 is a factor of, let this is px, px equal to 4x cube plus 3x square minus 4x plus k. Here the x minus 1 is factor given. So if x minus 1 is a factor given, it will be only when p a equal to 0. Similarly, if x minus 1 is a factor, what it implies? X minus a is a factor, p a equal to 0. So a equal to 1, if you take x minus 1 is a factor, that means p 1 equal to 0. Similarly, if x minus 1 is a factor, p 1 equal to 0 can be. This is factor theorem. P 1 means what? We have to replace this x by 1. So in every term, each and every term, we will replace x by 1. So it will be P 1 equals to 4 into 1 cube plus 3 into 1 square minus 4 into 1 plus k equal to 0. Equal to 0 as it is. Then 1 cube is 1 into 4, 4. 1 square is 1 into 3, 3. 1 into 4 minus 4, that is plus k equal to 0. Then what you will have? Plus 4 minus 4 cancel. 3 plus k equal to 0. So what will be k equals to? Plus 3 will be right side minus 3. So this is the value of k we get. Very simple. Example 13 now we have. Factorize 6x square plus 17x plus 5. By splitting middle term and by factor theorem. By two methods we have to find, by splitting the middle term and by factor theorem. So first we will see, by splitting middle term, 6x square plus 17x plus 5, middle term is 17x. We have to split this. This plus 17 we have written here. And how to split this 17? You know that in splitting method, first and last, 6, 5 are 30. Plus 30 should be multiplied and plus 17 should be addition. That way we have to split this 17. So if you do plus 15 and plus 2, by addition they will give plus 17, as well as 15 into 2 it will give 30 also. So splitting the middle term, 17 will be splitting in 15 and 2. So that we have split the middle term 6x square as it is. The middle term 17x is split as 15x plus 2x and plus 5 as it is. Now from two terms, first two terms, what is common there? 3 is common and x is common. So 3x is common taken. In bracket what is remaining? 3, 2s are 6, so 2, and x was square, so one time taken outside, one time remaining inside. Plus 3, 5s are 15, so 5 is there and x is 1 only taken. Plus in last two terms no common is there. If no common is there, we take common as 1 plus 1 and 2x plus 5 will be added. Now in both of the terms, 2x plus 5 bracket is common, that we have to write common 2x plus 5, and the remainings are 3x plus 1 that we have to write in second bracket. So this way the factors of 6x square plus 17x plus 5 are 2x plus 5 and 3x plus 1 by splitting middle term. That we have done in earlier classes also. Now the new is, by the factor theorem we want to factorize this. So now using factor theorem, Let consider the given polynomial Px equals to 6x square plus 17x plus y, given polynomial, of whose we want to find out the factors. Now, we will take the coefficient of x square 6 as common here. So 6 is going to be common, so it will be x square. Here 6 was not there, so 6 will be divided. So 17 upon 6 into x plus, here also 6 is not common, so we have to divide by 6, because 6 is taken out. Then check it, 6 if you multiply inside, 6x square, 6x and 17x, 6x and 5. So we have to take out 6 common, and then this term is like x square, this bracket is 6 into this bracket is x square plus 17 by 6 x plus 5 by 6. Now if a and b are two zeros of px, because it is quadratic polynomial, it may have, it will have two zeros, alpha, beta, and a and b in the same. So 6x square plus 17x plus 5 equals to, it will be 6 into, if a and b are two zeros, you know, the factors will be x minus a and x minus b. So that is written here, 6 into the factors of these are x minus a into x minus b. Now simplify this 6 here, 6 into x minus a into x minus b can be simplified as, can be expanded as x into x square minus x into a into x ex and b into x bx. From both of that x is common, so minus a plus b into x will be the middle term, plus at the end minus a into minus b, it will be minus minus plus a into b into b. Now compare this expanded form with this form, 6 into x square plus 17 by 6 x plus 5 by 6, and this is 6 into x square minus a plus b into x into ab. So this ab plays this constant term without x, here 5 by 6 is constant term without x. So therefore ab equal to 5 by 6, a into b equal to 5 by 6. So the possibilities of a and b are, a and b, all possible values we have to write, in which by multiplying both of that it should give 5 by 6. So there will be factors of 5 by 6 are plus or minus 1 is a factor of everything, you know. Plus or minus 1 by 2 is also a factor of this. Plus or minus 1 by 3 may be. Plus or minus 1 by 6 may be. Plus or minus 5 by 2, plus or minus 5 by 3, plus or minus itself 5 by 6. If you make the pairs of any two, not any two actually, special pairs we have to take on from these all. So by multiplying, they will give 5 by 6. It will be a trial and error. So all these values we will not check, but by trial of which two values we have taken, in this plus or minus 1 by 3, minus 1 by 3 if you place the possible value of a and b, as minus 1 by 3 if you take in this given expression, right, px. So p minus 1 by 3 equal to 6 times, this is in bracket, x square means minus 1 by 3 square plus 17 by 6, x means minus 1 by 3 plus 5 by 6. You simplify this, 6 into minus 1 by 3 square is 1 by 9, minus plus minus, 17 ones are 17 up and 6 threes are 18 down, plus 5 by 6 as it is, equal to 6 into 18 is LCM. We have to get 18 2 multiplied, 2 ones are 2, minus 17 as it is, plus to get 18 3 multiplied, 3 by 15. So here you can see 15 and 2, 17 plus 17 and minus 17 will be 0 upon 18. It will be 0, and 0 into 6 will be 0. So this is 0 coming. So p of minus 5 by 2 is 0, p of minus 1 by 3 is 0 coming. Similar way, in this plus or minus 5 by 2, if I take minus 5 by 2, this is my trial actually written, so each and every value you can check, but for every value it will not come 0, especially for these two values only, which we have checked, one this is, and the second one this minus 5 by 2, we are going to check, 6 into, again in this you have to put all the x values, x are minus 5 by 2 square plus 17 upon 6, x equal to minus 5 by 2 plus 5 by 6 as it is, 6 as it is, 5 minus 5 by 2 square will be 25.4, plus minus minus 17 by 85 upon 6 to 12 plus 5 by 6. Then 6 into 4, 12 and 6 LCM will be 12. To get here 12, 3 multiplied 25, these are 75. minus 85 as it is, so get here 12 to multiply 5 to 10. Here also if you see 75 and plus 10 plus 85 and minus 85 will be 0. 0 upon 12 will be 0 and 0 into 6 will be 0. So it is also 0. So by placing the replacing x value as minus 1 by 3, we are getting 0. And by placing in the polynomial minus 5 by 2 x value, we are getting 0. So by this factor theorem, when x minus a is a factor called if p a equal to 0. So here p minus 1 by 3 equal to 0. So x plus 1 by 3 and here minus 5 by 2 placing, we are getting 0. So x plus 5 by 2 are the factors of px by factor theorem. Since on p minus 1 by 3 is 0, x plus 1 by 3 is a factor, and since on minus 5 by 2, p minus 5 by 2 equal to 0, x plus 5 by 2 both are the factors of px. If both are factors of px, means they are by giving multiplication, they should give px. So px equal to, as 6 was given as it is, for this quadratic polynomial, two factors are x plus 1 by 3 and into x plus 5 by 2. So we can write the multiplication of two factors will give this bracket 6 as it is. Now equals to 6 as it is. In this bracket 3 is LCM. So it will be 3x plus 1 up. And in second bracket 2 is LCM. So it will give 2x plus 5 up there. Now this 3 down and 6 up. So 3 2s are 6. And this 2 up and 2 down will be cancelled. So which two brackets are remaining only? 3x plus 1 and 2x plus 5. This way using factor theorem we got the factors of 3x plus 1 and 2x plus 5 of the given px, 6x square plus 17x plus 1. So you can see that by splitting method also the same factors were there. So these are the two methods by splitting method middle term that we know in the earlier classes, and this is the new factor theorem using we can do this way. So in exam it can be asked, so you have to be careful how to use factor theorem to find the factors of the given polynomial, right?